The morning sun shines on the gleaming hide of a muscular ranch horse. The aroma of bacon and coffee drifts from the wood cook stove at a cow camp. Silver spurs jingle as the men and women of the West get set for another day in the saddle. From the heart of Canada's finest ranching country, this is the Spirit of the West with rancher and horse trainer Hugh McLennan and his collection of music, poetry, and conversations with the folks who live and work with horses and cattle in the Spirit of the West.
Our view of the world is influenced by the generation we're from to a certain extent. Shaped by world events, each generation has developed its attitudes and values and has a slightly different perspective. Those of us who were born before 1945 tend to be influenced by the effects of the Great Depression and World War II. Then the biggest demographic group, baby boomers, have experienced the post-war boom, the accelerated advance of technology, and the Vietnam experience and the rise and fall of TV westerns and the changing social and community standards. The generations since then have seen the swinging 60s, the Watergate years, and anyone born since 1980 has seen more changes than the last four generations have. And we're going to talk today a little bit about the effects of our Western cultures and values on North American attitudes. This week I managed to track down a singer and a songwriter who shares my passion for the values of the North American West. Royal Wade Kimes is writing, performing, and winning awards for his music. He's in Nashville, and we're going to talk about horses, heroes, and Western values today. The Horse Training File. We'll look at one of the simple situations that can have serious consequences. And cowboy and poet John Bowerman took his old cow horse to a high-level cutting competition, and that episode was immortalized in a piece of cowboy poetry called Cuttin' at the County Fair that you'll hear today.
What some of them don't realize is that horse shows are about as different from real cowboying as a Holstein cow is from a Hereford Range cow.
There's the news from the Rangeland and the latest on our Spirit of the West Caribbean cruise coming up today. And now the question, is the cowboy a dying breed? I'll talk with Royal Wade Kimes about that. He's the guy that wrote and sings this song.
Got a sorrel horse that he calls Old Fred. His Stetson hat seldom leaves his head. Spurs and cowboy boots all on his feet. They're worn out like him. He's a dying breed. When first light comes, he'll ride the rain. It breaks his heart in two to see his world change. It keeps getting smaller to meet the city folks' needs. They're buying up the land. He's a dying breed. Using four-wheelers now around the cattle. They're calling it progress, but he's calling it greed. He still respects the land, but he's a dying breed. Don't need no law to settle his fights. His heart tells him what's wrong, all right. He's the last of the old West that we're gonna see. He's living proof that they're a dying breed. Live on. sunshine breeze.
Wade Kimes from a CD that's getting a lot of attention these days, and he's on the phone from Nashville right now. Wade, what is the background behind that great song?
I rode the open range when I was a boy. From the time I was 12 years old, I was 22 years old, and I rode with some old timers that knew what it was about, and I enjoyed it, and that's gone. And so one day I was walking down Music Row Avenue, and you know me, Hugh, I wear a hat, I wear boots. That's what I guess I was born that way, you know. I don't remember wearing nothing else. And I was walking along with an old boy by the name of Kent Blazy, who wrote Tomorrow Never Comes for Garth Brooks. But he knew I was a cowboy, and we was walking along, and I said, you know, Kent, I said, I'm a dying breed. I said, look here on the row. I said, you don't see anybody wearing hats like me. I said, they put one on to go on stage with, but then they take it off immediately. I said, you know, I'm a dying breed. I said, but you know what? It's not dead out there. We got to keep this stuff alive. And Drake, he said, you know what? We got to go write that. So we ended up writing a song about that old cowboy that is trying to hang on to what's left, you know. And I think between you and me and a bunch of others like us, this thing's fixing to really blow wide open, and that cowboy thing's going to really be something in another couple, 3 years here.
Well, I think what's happened, Wade, is folks are recognizing from performers like yourself and other genuine cowboys who are really skilled that this music is real. You know, it's got a heart in it. And the events and the people and the horses that we sing about really exist.
You know, I lived it. And somebody asked me, well, how do you write songs like that? Well, the good songs come from the heart, and they come from living. And not knocking the kids today, but a lot of the kids they sign today, I hear a lot of the big label people say, well, you know, we got to write a story around this guy. But how do you write a story around a kid,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Mm-hmm.
And if you've done some living, which I think our audience out there can relate to, they know where we're coming from.
Yeah, a few of these miles down the trail kind of add a little character, I think, to the whole,
yeah.
the whole picture.
Well, if you enjoyed that first song, wait till you hear a couple of the new ones from Royal Wade Kimes. And coming up, the song about a horse that played a role in history, and he talks about his favorite horses. When the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Oh, the beautiful Caribbean. Famous for turquoise water, sailing, snorkeling, and hanging out on the beach with endless sunshine. That's where you could be enjoying the camaraderie of folks you'll have a lot in common with. The 2025 Spirit of the West cruise aboard the Majestic Princess, and you will see 8 of the Caribbean's most beautiful ports of call. Airfare is included. This is a 14-day Circle of Caribbean cruise. And for details, just call toll-free 1-800-530-0131. The 2025 cruise destination visits 9 fantastic ports of call, sailing round-trip from Fort Lauderdale. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. Royal Wade Kimes is on the line from an office down on Music Row in Nashville, but we're talking about the wide open spaces and the big western sky today. And Wade, on your website and in some of your promotion material, I've seen some pictures of you riding a good-looking sorrel horse, and that wouldn't be a horse called Old Fred like in the song, would it?
No, but that horse's name is Kokomo, and she's mine. Hugh, that's the smartest horse I ever owned. She's incredible. I mean, really a good horse. We won a little money on her team pinning and different things, but she loves a camera. She'll work a camera. We've shot 2 videos with her. She does really well with that. But Old Fred, he was back there a ways. He's done gone now.
Was he actually a real horse that kind of inspired
oh, yeah.
that line? Is that right? Was he one of yours?
Yeah, he's one of our... bunch that we had in the corral there for a long time. We mm-hmm. rode several different horses. At one time, I was wrangling 30 head of horses at once. It was a dude ranch that I did that on. In fact, you're going to know who it is. It's Loretta Lynn.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
When I left the range out west, I came out and worked for Loretta Lynn for about a couple of years there, and I wrangled 30 head of horses, and my first showman job was singing at the campfire shows for her.
There's a lot of other songs on here that really got to me. Of course, Nightbirds has been released as a single. It's doing pretty well, I think, on mainstream charts, isn't it?
We've got us a cowboy song out there on them charts now. It's at 56 with a bullet.
Wow.
Probably going to be about 50 with a bullet by tonight. It looks like we're waiting on a report on it. But that song is about, you know how cowboys are. They were restless, and they had to be on the move. You know, cowboys like to see country. But he run onto this little old gal, and he said, you know, I've seen a lot of towns, but one night with you might turn it all around. Then, of course, I got my old sidekick. A lot of people don't know this, but Garth Brooks is, he's quite the cowboy self. He loved that last cowboy record I had that had Boxcars and Barbed Wire on it. He wanted to be on this record. And I said, all right. He said, man, when I heard your last album, that cowboy record, he said, I love that cowboy stuff. I love what you're doing. And he said, I'd like to be a part of that thing. So we got together and we did this song. And I love that line. He says, one day I'll be an old man. But he said, they'll wonder why I'm smiling. It'll be these memories of mine. I mean, it's just such a cool thing that it does. It just gives the whole realm of what a cowboy, how he feels, you know.
Might get up in the morning, saddle my horse and leave. You never know, my darling, about a cowboy like me. I've always been a drifter, I've seen a lot of towns. But one night with you, love, I turn it all around. Hear the night birds are singing, love is in the air, and that warm breeze is blowing softly through your hair. Oh, that desert moon is our candlelight, and we're night birds in the dark. We found each other from the echoes of the heart.
Day I'll be an old man, look back upon this time, and they'll wonder why I'm smiling with these memories of mine. So hold me to your breast, girl, and let me feel the heat. This moment is frozen and forever it will keep. Hear the night burn.
Of course, having Garth on that certainly isn't going to hurt sales and no. The impact of it.
It kind of helps sales out, too. I mean, we're seeing a lot of movement on it. But yeah. I tell you what was funny about it. I had a couple of the mainstream radio stations call me, and one of them said, man, you snuck one in the back door on us. I said, what do you mean? He said, well, we saw this record, and we didn't know Garth was on it. And he said, we played a little of it and said, here's this cowboy thing. He said, and we got to tell you, we loved it. And then said, all of a sudden, here comes Garth on there. I said, that really surprised us. I said, so we didn't know what to make of it. He said, but you know what? You're going to have a cowboy record on mainstream radio. And I'm hoping I do. I just talked to Waddy Mitchell the other day, and Waddy told me, he said, man, I hope you pull this off because, you know, it just gives the cowboy even that much more of a toehold.
That's for sure. Yeah, and sometimes, and we've talked about this for years, and that's sometimes just what it takes because
yeah,
the product is there, but you need that little extra marketing push, and it seems to be working.
Well, you can see the, you know, you can kind of see the movement, especially down here where I'm at. I'm starting to see a little movement on it all the time.
You know, my big frustration, Wade, is I've got just racks and racks and racks of CDs, mostly from independent artists who are super talented. And the songwriting, you know, folks like Dan Roberts and, of course, Don Edwards and so many more.
R.W.
Hampton, and it just goes on and on and on. Robert Joel Vandegrift, and it's all airplay friendly. It would all work for mainstream stations, but because it's not, doesn't have the benefit of distribution from a major label, a lot of mainstream stations and music suppliers aren't even aware of it, you know.
No, that's
and
right.
When it something took me, like
it took me 3 years to get major distribution set up. You know, I'm on Wonderment Records, and I had some help from them, and I mean, but I really worked it myself. I flew everywhere. I done everything you could do. I was about ready to just throw in the towel. I thought, you know, cowboys don't throw in the towel, so I ain't giving up on this. We can get distribution some kind of way. Boy, and we started hammering till we drove every nail we could drive, and finally got it done, and finally got recognition. And I think once we get ours done and get it rolling, I think it's going to open up for all of it.
Coming up, a great story from the vault with Dr. Billy Beeman, the resident vet at Hawaii's famous Parker Ranch on the Big Island, when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West.
Stories from the vault, from the Spirit of the West. This is where we dig deep for some of the most amazing stories from the folks who bring some heartwarming, knee-slapping, spellbinding episodes.
And this one goes back a while to the highly respected equine vet, Dr. Marvin Beeman.
Can you bring to mind any specific episodes of doing that kind of surgery when everything did go wrong? Any horses that really maybe left a few bruise marks on you or anything like that? Any stories that you think back on?
Oh, yeah, I was doing it one day on a thoroughbred horse, and the rope came loose, and he kicked me in the mouth, and just mashed my upper lip, and that's when DMSO was the first available source of that DMSO, and he kicked me in the mouth, and my lip just went way out, stuck out about, seemed like a foot, and I put DMSO on my lip, and it went down really well, burned a little for a while, but then my wife thought I'd been eating garlic all day when I got home that night. And then I saw horses break their legs with that kind of restraint. And so it's a dramatic thing. And one of the fascinating things is when a horse had retained testicles, cryptorchids. That was a major, major surgery years ago. Now to tie in the advancements with the laparoscope, you just do a lot of those horses either under anesthesia or even standing, and you put the scope in their abdomen, you can see the testicle instead of doing it all blind and fishing for them. You can look in there, and then you make another portal. There's an instrument goes in, you get a hold of it, and they're castrated, and the horse doesn't even know that he had surgery. And it's just been really fascinating to see those kind of things happen. And it's like the surgery we just visited. We used to put the horses down on a table and slide them over onto a table or put them on a vertical table. That's where the big wrecks came. When you led a horse, a conscious horse, to anesthetize him up alongside of a table, then you had to give him the drugs and put belly bands on him, and everything had to work really well then to put them over in what we call on their side lateral recumbency. And the wrecks that came about, and then that's where you recovered them too. You let them start to get more and more conscious, and when you thought they could stand up, you tilted the table up, and hopefully they walked away. But about half the time, you had to lay them back down and go through a whole another process. And one time we had a horse that had a heart beat that wasn't working. And we were going to defibrillate the horse. And so we were using a shocking machine like it did on people. And we put that on that horse's chest and turned on the electricity. And Oh, man, you talk about a wreck. That mare jumped about 20 feet in the air. When we got that all done, her heart was better when we got done.
Took a while to clean up the clinic after that.
That's true. That's true.
If you're buying or selling farm machinery, heavy equipment, or trucks, let Progressive Auctions take the hassle out of your sale or your search. There's an online auction every Wednesday at progressiveauctions.ca. Doesn't matter where you live, Progressive Auctions can find the machinery or equipment you need or the buyers who are looking for what you're selling. ProgressiveAuctions.ca. For more information, call 844-309-9424. Just ahead of the Rangeland news, here's a great bunch of singing cowboys, including the longtime manager of the OH Ranch, Bud Maynard. It's the Bunch Grass Band, and I love this. There was a time.
Of issues and events from the world of agriculture.
At the top of page one, it says, you know, it sure doesn't seem like it, but maybe food prices at the grocery store have leveled off. At least, maybe they're not going up as fast as last year, and Gary Crawford checks it out.
As we pass the halfway point in 2024, the news on the cost of food continues to improve. Last month, the Agriculture Department was predicting that grocery store food prices would only go up an average of 1.2% this year. But now,
prices for food at home or groceries are predicted to increase by 1% in 2024.
Just 1%, this from USDA economist Megan Schweitzer, 1%.
And that's compared to last year, prices rose by 5%, and the previous year in 2022, prices rose by 11.4%.
So a 1% hike in grocery store food prices would be a welcome thing. But remember, this 1% is an average of all foods. Megan says we're still going to pay a little more for things like beef, but there are foods that will cost us less than a year ago, including fish and seafood and milk and dairy products. Gary Crawford for the U.S. Department of Agriculture.
The Honorable Lawrence McCauley, Minister of Agriculture and Agri-Food for Canada, has announced an investment of more than $6 million in two beef and cattle organizations through the Agri-Marketing Program, an initiative under the Sustainable Canadian Agricultural Partnership, and it aims to drive the growth of Canada's beef industry through promotional activities that increase awareness and demand for Canadian beef in existing and in new markets. Canada Beef is receiving $5,865,110, and the Canadian Cattle Association is receiving up to $453,364. The two group projects incorporate promotional activities like advertising campaigns. Hey, try the Spirit of the West, guys. Incoming and outgoing trade missions, technical training, and educational seminars. Six horses in Ontario recently tested positive for strangles. According to the EDCC Health Watch in Prescott, Russell County, a yearling standardbred filly tested positive in June after arriving from another farm in Ontario in November, and two additional horses at the private facility are exposed. And in Peterborough County, five horses at a private facility tested positive. The farm owner is working with the veterinarians to implement movement restrictions and infection control measures. Strangles in horses is an infection caused by the Streptococcus equi subspecies equi and spread through direct contact with other equines or contaminated surface. Horses that aren't showing clinical signs can harbor and spread the bacteria, and recovered horses remain contagious for at least 6 weeks with the potential to cause outbreaks long term. A vaccine is available, but not always effective, and biosecurity measures of quarantining new horses at a facility are vital. The Canadian Food Inspection Agency has released their long-promised update to National Feed Requirements and Regulations. Formerly referred to as the Feed Regulation 2024, the final version of the framework was registered on June 17th and published for public view July 3rd in Part 2 of the Canada Gazette. And the new requirements will be introduced gradually. Labeling rules and compositional and safety standards came into effect on July 3rd, with a one-year transition period where industry can follow either the existing or the new requirements. The old rule changes were in force immediately, and that included removing mink and foxes from the definition of livestock, approval and regulation and registration requirements, feed content standards, rules around feed for export, risk investigation procedures, record-keeping requirements, and exceptions noted in both the Fed's regulation in 2004 and the Fed's Act. Well, keep your calendars ready for September 13th to the 15th at the Caroline Cowboy Poetry and Music Festival. Folks like B.J. Smith, Ben Crane, Ed and Gail, Peaky Coot, Doris Daly, Doc Mill, the Traveling Mabels, Eli Barzee, and John Cunningham coming all the way out from Manitoba. And Old Ugly John Glosson, Tom Cole, and so many more. And just go to Caroline Cowboy Poetry and Music Festival for all the details. And I think tickets are still available at the Caroline Hotel. And the Canadian Bridal Horse Association is offering two open events this year, one in Alberta, one in BC. Skills of the Outfits East of the Rockies is going on right now, today the 3rd and the 4th, at the Silver Slate Arena, Stavely, Alberta. And Skills of the Outfit West of the Rockies, September 20th, 21st, and 22nd at the Barrier Fairgrounds, Barrier, BC. And both workshops, of course, will feature a demo by the master horseman Miles Kingdon, a bridle horse and stockmanship competition, and a maker's market at the Alberta event. And you can get all the information at CanadianBridleHorse.com. August the 9th, regular cattle sale at the Vanderhoof Yards of the BC Livestock Co-op. August 13th, regular and yearling cattle sale at the Kamloops Yards. April 22nd, Williams Lake regular sale. Get all the information at bclivestock.bc.ca, and you can watch all the sales streaming live right there. Meanwhile, at the Innisfail Auction Market, Innisfail, Alberta, regular cattle sales as they've been for so long, every Wednesday starting right at 9 o'clock with all classes of cattle. And you can check the markets and get all the information at InnisfailAuctionMarket.com or call Danny, Mark, or Dwayne at 1-800-710-3166. This item, the democracy will cease to exist when you take away from those who are willing to work and give to those who would not. Those words spoken between 1743 and 1826 by Thomas Jefferson. And now, the final item. I get a lot of interesting questions from listeners. Most of them deal with horse training, but sometimes folks wonder about training other kinds of animals. One of the strangest questions I had this week was from a guy who asked me if I could tell him how to make an elephant fly. When I was easy, I told him just start with a zipper that's 4 feet long. And that's the Rangeland News. Coming up on the Irvin Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File, the subject of safety plays a big part when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. Coming right up in the Irvin Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File, something a lot of us has done many times, but it's probably not a good idea. First, though, oh, the beautiful Caribbean. Famous for turquoise water, sailing, snorkeling, and hanging out on the beach with endless sunshine. That's where you could be enjoying the camaraderie of folks you'll have a lot in common with. The 2025 Spirit of the West cruise aboard the Majestic Princess, and you will see 8 of the Caribbean's most beautiful ports of call. Airfare is included. This is a 14-day Circle of Caribbean cruise. And for details, just call toll-free 1-800-530-0131. The 2025 cruise destination visits 9 fantastic ports of call, sailing round trip from Fort Lauderdale.
Now it's time for the Horse Training File, brought to you by Irvine Tack and Western Wear, Canada's largest Western store.
Ladies, if your calendar's not full right now, it soon will be, and Irvine Tack and Western Wear has everything you need for every occasion. For rodeo season, you'll find the top names in Western Wear with a welcome twist, Wrangler, Ariat, Rock and Roll, Times, and more. Irvine's has a 12,000 square foot department dedicated to ladies' wear and accessories, jeans, shirts, belts, hats, and dresses to dance the night away. And of course, the perfect pair of boots, scootin' boots, too. Exit 305 off Highway 2 by Crossfield.
The world's greatest Western store.
Now, the Horse Training File. Ever seen somebody tie their horse up to a post, a rail, a tie stall, tie ring on a trailer, and then walk under the horse's neck and under the lead shank? Bet you have, and I used to do it all the time, until, as I walked under the rope, the horse pulled back hard. Now, if the halter shank or hardware doesn't break, what's the next thing that horse is going to do? You got it. Jump ahead. And if you're in front of him, he could land right on top of you. And that has caused a few bad wrecks, and I'd suggest not walking under the halter shank when the horse is tied up. If you want to go to the other side of the horse when he's tied up, I believe it's safer to walk towards his rump with your hand gently on his back so he knows exactly where you are. Then keep your hand over his rump and walk behind him. Stay right close to him as you pass around to his other side. Let's say you're going from his left to his right side. At one point, he'll lose you with his left eye, and he has to pick you up with his right eye. And as long as he knows where you are, he can make that change and you'll be safe. Thousands of experienced horsemen have been doing this for years, and very few of them have ever been hurt. Even in the unlikely event that he does kick, as long as you're in close, you won't get the full force. It sure beats having him land in your lap if you're in front of him underneath the halter shank.
And for Irvin Saddles and Western Wear, that's the Horse Training File. Every day, you know, our horses get their daily feeding of Hoffman's horse ration. Boy, they look forward to it, and they sure do well on it. You can find all about it at hoffmanshorseproducts.com.
You can forget all about combing and searching all over the place to locate tractor parts. Check out the most convenient place to find parts for any make, bztractorparts.com. Massey Ferguson, Ford, John Deere, David Brown, Case, International Harvester, Universal, Deutz, Lightland, Landini, Oliver Flat, Alley, Zegar, White, and so many more. Just call 250-395-0960. Email bztractorparts56@gmail.com.
The horses of the Old West played a big part in the ongoing battle between right and wrong. Royal Wade Kimes wrote about such a horse. He'll talk about the horse after the song.
The sheriff rides a horse he calls Boogeyman, a big bay horse stands 16 hands thereabouts. He's sure enough stout, so don't break a law, cause you can't run, you can't hide from what you've done. What you gonna do if the man's after you? Comes Boogeyman. Boogeyman, Boogeyman on your trail. Boogeyman, Boogeyman, he never fails. Outlaw Saint, he was sure your name right, cause there's a devil in that horse that sure was dark in the night. Take the sheriff on his back, I bet the outlaw fears, but the stride of that stud and hooves drawing near. Comes Boogeyman. Up, chomping at the bits, give him some rain, cause there ain't no quit. Be gone, hang on, comes Boogeyman. Boogeyman, Boogeyman on your trail. Boogeyman, Boogeyman, he never fails. I'll say he was sure name right, cause there's a devil in that horse that sure was dark. And who's drawing near? Comes Boogeyman. Boogeyman, Boogeyman on your trail. Boogeyman, Boogeyman, he never fails.
Royal Wade Kimes and Boogeyman, boy, that one moves you along, Royal.
Yeah, I had a trucker tell me that, he said, man, I have to watch it when I'm playing that song, I get the speed.
That's right. Yeah, well, that's in the CD player in the pickup, we're going down the road, you gotta be a little careful.
Yeah, that's a good little song. I always wanted to write a song about a horse that, you know, you couldn't get away from him, you couldn't lose him, you know, you can just see this old horse if you listen to the song. You can just see him. He's lathered up. He's striding, you know.
Yeah, yeah, and you can just feel that. And, boy, you don't realize how much the horse put into some of those great chases and escapes.
Yeah, Jesse James, one of the reasons why he was so successful getting away every time was because he had a good eye for a good horse, and he always kept a real running horse under him. Hmm. And I usually had a pair of them. And so they had a hard time with him. They had a little thoroughbred blood in them, and they had a little trouble with him catching up. They couldn't catch him.
I didn't realize that.
Yeah.
Coming up, you will hear how Eddy Arnold was a big help when Royal Wade Kimes was trying to get a break in Music City. Well, this was a shock. Rick and Casey Peden were a great Western music duo. Casey has the voice of an angel, and her dad, Rick, was a fine singer, songwriter, and guitar player, and they played the Kamloops Cowboy Festival many, many times. And I just found out that Rick had passed away on January the 12th. He was only 77. Casey is still singing a lot with places like the Saskatoon Symphony Orchestra, and this, I guess, could be a rare collector's item, the only album they ever recorded together, and it's a song that Rick wrote, and he sang with his daughter Casey, called The Choice.
Well, sometimes late at night, when that moon is shining so knees and played the part that you had wanted me to do. I've never sailed an ocean tide, but I've crossed the great divide, drove a thousand head up through those whispering pines. I guess the choice I made was right, except sometimes late at night my mind goes wandering back to days when you were
and touch on the keyboard, and Rick's beautiful guitar, and a wonderful song. Rick will certainly be missed. The Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. Royal Wade Kimes is referred to as the Gentleman Outlaw, top songwriter in Nashville these days, and it all started out with a chance encounter with a country music legend. And Wade, before you go, we got to hear the story of how you were discovered by Eddy Arnold.
Well, I'd been there 2 years in Nashville, and I'd got down to, I had 25 cents in my pocket, and I was sleeping in my truck, and I had one tank of gas left, and it was dead of winter, I was freezing to death, and trying to make it to music business, and it looked like I was getting out faster than I was getting in, and I walked into him just straight out on the street one day, and we just started talking, and I said to him, I said, Mr. Arnold, I said, look, I said, I'd like to talk to you, I said, I don't want nothing. I just need you to tell me something. He said, tell you what you do. He said, come on down to my office. And so I went down there where he was at and had this little tape in my pocket, and I handed it to him. And I said, I just want you to tell me if I got it. And if I don't got it, then I'll get in that old truck I'm sleeping in and head home. But I've been here 2 years, and nobody will listen to me. And he listened to that tape, and now it's history. I'm here talking to you. I mean, it's like he just started picking up the phone and calling everybody, and he even got me a job, and he's just like a second dad to me now.
The cattle are prowling, the coyotes are howling, way out where the donkeys bawl. Where spurs are a-jingling, a cowboy is singing this lonesome cattle call. Till his day's work is done, as he rounds up the cattle each fall. Singing his cattle call. And he sings with an old western drawl. Ooh-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, singing his cattle call.
Up too much longer, because I know you got people that you've got to talk to and everything, but I'd like
to... I got a whole office full of people in here.
Okay, it's really great to be able to talk about the things that are so important to both of us and that we have a passion for, and
yeah.
Thanks for sharing a little bit of time here on
the
Spirit of the West.
I sure appreciate you, and I appreciate all the things you're doing for this movement.
Well, maybe we'll be able to either get horseback together somewhere or sit down and at least have a coffee and talk face-to-face again.
Hey, I'd love to.
Okay. All
we'll
of
rock
us...
and roll. We'll ride the range together sometime.
That would be just great.
All right.
Thanks for doing this, Wade.
See you later.
You betcha.
And now for some homegrown cowboy poetry. This one is called Cuttin' at the County Fair. The guy who did it is John Bowerman, and John rides that big sagebrush range near Fossil, Oregon. John, what's the story here?
Well, a lot of people can't survive on cowboy wagers, but they can own a horse and play cowboy on the weekends at horse shows. And what some of them don't realize is that horse shows are about as different from real cowboying as a Holstein cow is from a Hereford range cow. I went to the cutting at the county fair, took my old cow pony with his shaggy hair. He's a sure enough horse for a buckaroo, a rim rocker, a roper, and a cutter too. He could slip in the herd and sneak one out, never get him riled or choused about, so I figured we might do okay when we went into the cutting that day. But cutting on a ranch is a different thing than cutting in one of those horse show rings. The names of the horses they'd announce was like foreign words I couldn't pronounce. And the riggins, they was different too. Their shaps was purple and red and blue. Those saddles, they had great big swells. You'd be trapped for sure on a bronc that fell. One fella rode in to start the cut, brought out about half of those critters, but then he spilled them, all but one. About that time, things come undone. Had two herd holders trying to make a hand, but it seems they didn't understand how to hold the cut or nothing about, cause they shoved back everything he brung out. About the time he's getting it all together, well, he dropped the reins and went to pulling leather. I watched for an hour or thereabout, and they never got a single cow cut out. I looked at the fancy horses and rigs they had. I didn't want to make those folks feel bad. So I took my old cow pony with his shaggy hair and rode away from that cutting at the county fair.
Royal Wade Kimes has a great website. It's thegentlemanoutlaw.com, and that's where you can order all of his music and find out all about him. Thanks again for making the ride, and I sure hope you can join us right here next week at the same time. And as always, thanks to Mark and Kathy McMillan, our great support crew. Now be sure to check the latest issue of Canadian Cowboy Country Magazine for all kinds of great reading and pictures, and you can subscribe online at canadiancowboy.ca. Be sure to check out our YouTube channel for this show and many more from the past, with video and lots of videos of the Western Spirit Band and ranching scenes and much more. The links are on our website, hugh-mcclennan.com. Till next week, I'm Hugh McLennan. Hope to see you down the trail somewhere real soon.